you're hearing is the sound card I have in my vintage CompuAdd 810. It's a NEC V20 CPU, which is basically an enhanced version of the 8088, running at almost 10 megahertz. I think it's 9.54 megahertz. The hard drive's on top here because I normally don't have it installed. I just installed it for this demonstration here of this sound card. It is a Packard Bell. Come on, focus. I guess that's a little better. It's a Packard Bell clone of the original Sound Blaster. It's only a mono card. And it has the oldest version of the MIDI synthesizer chip, the OPL2, as compared to the OPL3 that was used in the Sound Blaster Pro and the Sound Blaster 16. So you're getting the original sound of MIDI music that was first used in sound cards. I have it hooked up to my Tandy monitor here. Let me adjust my exposure so you can see it better. This is the program it came with to play MIDI files in DOS. And these are all the sample songs it came with. And I'm going to do a direct hookup. You heard it playing through the speaker I rigged up inside the case. But I just built a jury-rigged D-pad so I can hook this up to the microphone input of this camera. So then you'll hear the direct sound. Let me hook up the output of it. Into the card. Alright, now I'll hook it up to the camera. Thank you. you can hear, it has a very different sound than even the sound cards of the 90s because of this early MIDI chip. The instruments are different, the drums are different, and even if you try to take these same files and play on a modern sound card, they usually don't come out right because they use a different channel for the drums. So what you would, what the MIDI was designed to play the drums through a certain channel, that channel is now assigned to instruments, so instead of drums you get like guitars and pianos playing along to the drum track. So, kind of neat. Still works fine. Same can't really be said about this MiniScribe hard drive. Every time I turn it on, I have to manually move the heads back and forth to get it to unstick. It's one of the main reasons why I don't keep it installed in the computer, because otherwise it just... Every time I would have to take the computer apart just to get it started. So, that's the vintage Packard Bell sound card. It's actually made by Aztech. It's called an Aztech... Come on, exposure. Aztech Sound Galaxy is the name of the card. That's their software. So there you go, vintage old school MIDI on a PC. Thanks for watching.